On the northern edge of San Antonio, Texas, surrounded by tidy subdivisions, sits a small subterranean cavern, accessible only through a narrow opening.
But Friesenhahn Cave harbors an ancient mystery of epic proportions.
Tens of thousands of bones have been found here from over 30 different species of animals. It has one of the greatest concentrations of fossils from the Pleistocene era in North America.
The sheer concentrations of specimens is stunning. It definitely raises a giant question. How could so many ancient creatures end up in one small cave that's only reachable by a single 30-foot shaft?
Could these remains be evidence of a previously undocumented mass extinction? Or could thousands of animals have been washed into the cavern by a flood of biblical proportions? What really happened in Friesenhahn Cave? I'm heading there to try to get to the bottom of this prehistoric mystery.
I grew up as a kid in Dallas, in the outskirts of the city. And I used to walk around in forests just like this, and the idea of finding a cave in one of the forests that I grew up in is just awesome.
In fact, the cave was discovered by local residents in the early 1900s. Inside, archaeologists excavated the remains of a beast from the Ice Age, the Columbian mammoth. This massive mammal could reach 14 feet at the shoulders. When it roamed, this area would have been grassland, like Oklahoma or parts of Colorado today. Grazing animals, including giant megafauna, dominated the ancient landscape of Texas.
Oh! This is a massive hole. Whoa! Obviously, they have it gated off right now so nobody falls in or goes in.
Today, the site is controlled by Concordia University, but they've given me special access to go down and explore.
Right up above us, 30 feet, is a flat forest, and then you come down here and you're in a different world.
I quickly see just what makes this cave so remarkable.
This whole side is just covered in bones. That's a fossil right there. It's either some sort of bone or a mammoth tusk. Clear as day. Oh my gosh. This could very well be the teeth of some sort of large mastodon or mammoth.
Many of the bones found in this cave have been from animals of the Ice Age.
The concentration of those bones is so extreme right here. I keep finding new ones. Like they're literally stacked on top of each other, one bone after the next.
It's hard to escape the feeling that something really big happened here.
Are we looking at essentially a mass extinction event?
Scientists have identified 5 previous mass extinctions over the past 500 million years. The first was 450 million years ago, when 85% of marine species disappeared. It may have been triggered by a burst of gamma rays generated by a nearby supernova. The last, and probably most famous, was about 65 million years ago, when scientists believe a massive asteroid hit the planet, triggering a series of events that led to the death of the dinosaurs. Could this unassuming hole in the ground in central Texas be evidence of another, as yet unidentified, apocalypse?
What we would have to do in this cave is scour the walls, look for evidence of something that may have caused that extinction event.
I know that volcanic eruptions have played a part in previous extinctions, and they often leave behind geologic evidence. Many volcanic rocks have easily identifiable structures like glassy, like obsidian, or grainy and rough, like basalt. But as I run my hands along the walls of the cave, I'm not finding these.
The problem is, looking at this cave, it seems to be all composed of the same material, limestone. As you can see, calcium carbonate is dripping off of the roof of this cave. This is very typical of a limestone cave.
It certainly seems that these species were not the victims of a cataclysmic eruption. So then what killed all these ancient animals? It's dark down here, and my visibility is extremely limited. I suspect there are more clues here that can't be detected by the naked eye.
I think the best way to figure out what's going on here is just to run a 3D scan. I'm hoping that by stepping back and looking at this 3D image, we can start to understand this area more.
I've called in subterranean scanning specialists Rick Walker and Tress Smith.
Well, I'm excited to see what we're able to find. Shall we start it?
Let's go.
To create a detailed 3D model of the cave, Rick and Tress have brought in one of the most powerful LiDAR scanners on the market. LiDAR stands for light detection and ranging. By emitting an array of up to 1 million laser pulses per second, this device can capture all the crevices that light doesn't penetrate.
What are you doing over here, Rick?
I'm gonna set up this scan target here so we can have a point of reference.
So you're just screwing that to the old...
Yeah, then actually this one's
bolting it into the wall, basically.
Right.
The scan targets will help calibrate the device. Once those are in place, we can finish setting up the machine.
This is much bigger than I've seen before. I mean, this is a beefy device right here.
So this is an industrial application. This actually is built in a big case because there's a lot going on.
Right.
This is made to withstand anywhere from an extreme desert environment to they actually scan glaciers in the Arctic with these.
Oh, no way.
They
really?
Do.
So essentially what we've got here, the laser is going to come out right here.
That's correct.
And they're going to more or less spin like this, and then the whole device will spin around.
It'll go through and it's going to spin its laser, and we're going to see possibly a red line as it works the room in a 360-degree fashion.
Right. I'm guessing we shouldn't be looking at the laser when this thing goes, right?
That's correct. This is a class one laser. It's not ideal. It's no harmful radiation, but just don't look directly at it when it's working.
All right, let's do it.
The LiDAR lasers could damage our cameras, so we can't film the process. But I'm excited to see the 3D model it's going to create.
So I just got the LiDAR images. Let's see what they show. Oh, wow, that's so cool. So we're looking at the cave from the outside right now. What I have to do is I have to get inside of it. This is unprecedented detail. And to be able to see it in colors, the colors indicating the hardness, that allows us to see things so much differently.
The red indicates softer materials like sediment. The blue, harder materials like limestone.
The floor of this cave is clearly much softer than the ceiling. That makes sense. The floor of the cave was essentially sediment washed in with rainwater, built up over time. The ceiling of the cave, it makes sense that it's harder because limestone is pretty hard in material. Look at this right in here. That is softer sediment, apparently on the wall of the cave. I did not expect that. So potentially this is why all these mammoth bones are in here. They just got washed here with a giant flood.